Hey, hey, Blue Table fans. Got an extra special treat for you today. This is a an Eldar army done to level 4. Thank you. Yeah, that's great. Done to level 4, and it's just has a very striking color scheme, so let's just dive right in and take a look. The counterpoint colors here are somber gray, which is the equivalent of Space Wolf's gray for Vallejo, and also this ivory color, which I think works very well with the purple and teal. And then you have these orange spots where it just makes them pop. And in fact, without the orange, it might not look as good. But if you're going to use orange with a color scheme like this, boy, you better be ready. You better be ready to, take a little risk on that. So here's a Crimson Hunter. This is all magnetized, by the way. It has a huge amount of magnetized options. Something interesting here is the secondary weapon is underneath the arm. You can kind of see it where my finger is there. And I really like that. The shoulder mount is probably not for everybody. I personally like it. I like this where the guy's looking at the same direction that the shoulder mount is. Some people actually magnetize this bottom part too to make it completely removable, which I think is a nice feature. You've got a Night Spinner here, one of my favorite models and things in the game. These weapon platforms don't have the weapons on them, but they are magnetized. Bunch of warp spiders, an absolutely great unit in the new edition, and they're now fine cast, which makes them not fall over as much as they used to. We've got some Farseers here, and again, all the different colors incorporated on there. And pretty cool stuff. I love the, this is really this fade on the Guardian's gun. Really add something, but that of course could have been straight up orange as well. Now at Blue Table Painting we have what different types of basing styles, but there's different grades of them. The lowest one is basic, what's called basic bases. Then you have decorative bases. Decorative bases have like a single element, like a rock or a skull or a little bush or something put on them. And then there are what are called specialty bases, which will actually have something unusual, like some kind of almost narrative element to them. So that's the three levels: basic, decorative, and specialty. So anyway, over here we have some Rangers, again with the ivory as a really good accent, in my opinion. Now, lastly, let's take a look at these jet bikes. And these have Guardian torsos, which is absolutely the only way to fly with Eldar jet bikes. Basically, you just have to buy one Guardian per jet bike. They do need some finagling to make sure that the waist fits, but other than that, they go on really nice. Here, I do believe you have a Dire Avenger torso, so all of these guys have little bits of uniqueness on them, which I think is really cool. And so, folks, that is what we have to show you today. Here at Blue Table Painting, we produce, on average, one army a day at this time. And we just plain don't have time to show you everything. But it'd be really cool. For a long time, I wanted to do it for at least a week. So thanks for tuning in, and I hope you got your inspiration for the day. Gosh, are you guys done?
Yeah.
Who won?
They did.
Did they?
It was actually a close game. It was a close game.
All right.
It's not close as I thought it was, yeah. Like, poison kind of hurts against Toughness 5 stuff. It's like,
We didn't have any poison, though.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah, you did.
My poison had poison.
We didn't have enough poison.
We didn't have enough poison, obviously.